has been quite a bumpy ride this evening. We've done our very best.
Turbulence, I barely slept at all. Alright, just made it to central London. I'm at London Paddington Station. Took the Heathrow Express train. It's never in Heathrow Airport, the fastest way to get to the city is the Heathrow Express. If you're on a budget, you can take the underground, of course, but I value time more than money. So, I mean, it's important, and I tried to, you know, when we were in London at the event, I really tried to make you guys see that you don't need to know a whole lot. Like, the stuff you already know, you can already turn into a product, you can already turn into a service, into an ebook, and keep it simple. You don't need to buy, you don't need to write a 50-page ebook that nobody's gonna read, you know, that's also what I said. Something, write something simple, 10, maybe 5 pages, 10 pages, but really go straight to the point, give people that value, and tell them how they can continue to work with you, what can they do to get in touch with you, or, you know, there are just so many options. It's actually quite exciting when you think about all the options that you have.
Yeah.
You're writing it down?
Yes.
What else do you think should be on your list for the next 60 days that you need to tackle?
I'd like to see some money generating here pretty quick. That would be cool.
That would be cool.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure, I know, you know, it took you, what, 4 years to start, you know, actually getting some things going, but...
Oh, well, that was me, and I was very slow, and I was not, you know, during that period, I was not attending any seminars or investing in any mentors. That's why it took so long. I tried to learn and do everything myself, and I didn't want to pay anyone money. So the moment that I changed that switch where, wait a minute, you know, I cannot do this on my own, and I need somebody to show me the way, or I need to buy some courses or some seminars, then things started to speed up a little bit. And you're already doing that.
Right.
Shouldn't take you that long if you're taking massive action. If you want to start seeing money, I mean, obviously, if you set up your store, right, and then you start setting up your ads, or you start building your database, those are all things that that can turn into money if you do it right. And I think you got the tools.
Yeah.
What do you think you can do?
I just got to implement them and start getting them. I just need to spend like a day or two just concentrating on this on the computer and just get it done.
It really is a day or two. I mean, for those things, it's a day or two.
Yeah. Using the ClickFunnels to help with, I guess you use the ClickFunnels to help with the advertising?
Yeah, I mean, the way that I use ClickFunnels or any other software or platform to build web pages is as a way to funnel people into your brand and into your business. So,
okay.
So for example, let's say you come up with your lead magnet. You would build a quick funnel using ClickFunnels or any other software you want to use. There's Lead Pages, there are a bunch of others. I like ClickFunnels because it's very, very complete. That would be the way for you to actually collect people's emails and have upsells and offers. People enter their email to download your ebook or whatever, and then there is a confirmation page with a video of you. Hey, this is Daryl, thank you so much, or congratulations for taking action, and then you invite them to take another action. So that's how you start funneling them. Some people will take,
okay.
Some people will only click your ad, they will take no action. Some people will give you their email and get your lead magnet. Some people will take you up on a free consultation call or buy your upsell. Or, I mean, to get a certain amount of people to take the most important action that you want them to take, you need to get a lot of people to actually click, then a few more people to give you their email, then a few more people to do. Once you are clear on what you're going to offer, then you will need a funnel.
Well, so what that is basically, so once I get these going and do my own advertising on here, the ClickFunnels is a wider spectrum for me to get a wider audience.
Yes, I mean, ClickFunnels, it's basically the platform that you're going to use to offer your product or service, in a way that is attractive, right? Where you build a website. It's more than just a website. It's a way to get people into your universe, so to speak, and to buy your products and services. A website is, when you think of a website, is something a little more static, where it's just a page and about me, like a biography or a few links here and there. But a funnel, you can build a funnel every time you have something new that you want to offer. And that's basically what I do for every ebook that I have, or for every affiliate program that I'm offering or promoting, for every event that I do. For example, the page that you saw where you applied for my event, that was a ClickFunnels page.
Okay.
So imagine how many pages you yourself click on regularly, and think and start looking at them differently now. Now, for me, every time I click on an ad, I analyze it from a marketer's perspective and not just from a consumer perspective. I'm like, okay, why did I click on this ad? What worked? Why did it work on me? And what can I learn from it? And what can I take so that I can implement in my own ads or my own funnels, you know?
Yeah, what do you like about it, and why did you click on it?
Correct. Why did it appeal to you? All right, guys. Well, today I basically got to my hotel room. It's a very tiny room that I'll be sharing with my friend Maya. My friend Maya is coming over tomorrow. We're both going to the Conor Oberst concert and the Muse concert Friday and Saturday. She was briefly in one of my episodes of the vlog of June, because she's a really good friend of mine, and she's from the Netherlands. And when I was in Amsterdam, I was hanging out with her for a bit. We went to the Barbie Peep Show and all that stuff. Anyway, right now I'm just gonna head out. I took a nap. I did the client call. Hope you got some value from some of the things that I discussed with my client Daryl. And he was one of the attendees of my Marketing Rockstars Live workshop in London in July. And when people get VIP tickets for my workshops, I normally provide extra support for them via phone calls or Skype calls for a few months, just to make sure that they're implementing, that they keep their momentum going. That goes to you if you ever want to come to my events, which, by the way, my next event is coming up in October in the US. So I'm gonna be there in October. More information will be published very soon, as soon as I got all the details for it. Anyway, so just took a shower. Now I'm gonna go grab some food. I also need a new SIM card for my phone, and that's it. Now, this is the view from my hotel. It's actually not very interesting, but we are close to the Shepherd's Bush Empire venue. It's a small venue in London, but it's very known. Shepherd's Bush Empire. Now it's called O2 Shepherd's Bush, because O2 bought them, I think. So yeah, that's it. I might report back when I come back from dinner, or you know, because, you know, guess what, where I'm going. If you've been paying attention to my vlogs the last 2 months, then you know every time I come to Europe, well, specifically London, and every time I go to the US, there is one store that I always go to, Whole Foods. So that's where I'm gonna have some healthy dinner, and I'm gonna go grab the new SIM card. Anyway, I'm rambling. I'll see you guys in a bit. Remember to make your life a masterpiece. I'll see you in a bit. All right, guys, so I made it to Whole Foods, and right now I'm going through their healthy buffet, which is always a mess for me, because I want to try everything. There's just all this delicious food that looks great. The good thing, I only go for the vegan stuff, so that way I have fewer choices, which is actually really, really good anyway. What is your favorite health food store? I'd love to know, and tell me the country, tell me the city, the name, so that if I ever visit your city, I can try at your favorite health food store. Anyway, I'm gonna grab some fruits as well. As you can see, very large selection. This is a big Whole Foods. I'd never been to this one in particular.